Wine Gardner, Mr. 100%. Okay.
Is Fuji International Speedway. A speedway it definitely is, as you're about to find out, but the international part, well, that's up for debate, because you see, Fuji today is very much a Japanese affair. In a couple of hours' time, there'll be 80,000 race fans here to see round two of the All Japan Grand Touring Championship. There literally is just a handful of international drivers here, and one of them they call Mr. 100%.
I love you.
You love me? Thank you.
I love you.
Oh, thank you.
I love you, okay?
Okay.
Okay, I love you.
大丈夫ですか?
I love you.
Oh, ありがとう. ありがとうございました.
トラック!
ありがとう.
They are different, these Japanese motor racing fans. As different as the men they are mad about are fast. Wayne Gardner knows fast. He lived and breathed it. Broke bones and smashed lap records for it, all to become a Grand Prix motorcycle world champion. He still has that racer's spirit. Still finds less than best an unthinkable thought. In some ways, Wayne Gardner and Japan are a perfect match.
Well, Wayne, life in Japan and here in Tokyo, especially today, is a little bit different to back home. This is a good blessing for the district, and we're certainly having a good time, aren't they?
Certainly are. You probably got the right answer there. It is very different, isn't it, in Japan? And yeah, it's pretty neat. I mean, they're blessing the district, and yeah, it's a lot of action, and it's kind of fun. It's a good vibe here.
What brought you back to Japan to go to GT racing?
Well, you know, I wanted to get out of Australia. I wanted to go and do some other motor racing, and the opportunity arose with a test, and I came up here and tested, and here we go. I really liked it. I liked the travel. I liked the country. People are very nice, very friendly. So here I am racing in Japan, and I love it. You know, it's fun up here.
How did the link with Toyota come about, though?
Well, I tested originally about 4 years ago with one of the other teams, in fact, Saad team that Ralph drives for. And straight away I was quick, and I drove for them for a year, and they were on Yokohama tyres and they weren't that good, so I got off. I said I wanted to get on some Bridgestone tyres, and I asked Toyota, and so they then put me into another team, and then they struggled a bit, the team, then they went broke, and so then now they put me into this team, so I've sort of lucked out there a little bit. Ended up with now the best car and the best team and the best tyres, so the whole thing's actually worked very, very well for me now.
Is it a long, long way from the V8s back home, the supercars, the whole series and the feeling about it all?
Oh yeah, not even any comparison. You know, the series, well, the races are 2 hours long with two drivers. The cars are vastly different, as you can see. You know, the crowds are pretty big. You've got 130 million people up here in Japan. It's the second largest economy in the world. So, you know, with those sorts of ingredients, you know, it's a good recipe for a great series and a great race. So, yeah, it's pretty entertaining up here. Not only is it good racing, but it's lots of action in the streets.
I think we better jump out of the way before we get mown down.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know,
over here, of course, as Mr. 100%. How did that all come about?
Well, that's from my motorcycle days. I came here at a time, in the middle 80s, and every time I raced a Suzuka or any racetrack in Japan, I won. And I think I had like 12 wins or something in a row, and the Japanese then started calling me, I'm Mr. 100%. So it's kind of stuck from those days, and now it's on four wheels. Not doing as much winning now on four wheels. It's a lot more difficult, a lot more involved, but yeah, the name's still stuck, and I've still got my fans here.
Well, the Masaki Trident here weighs 1,000 kilos. I think there's a few bikes in there putting in 100% at the moment to carry that down to the next district.
They have to, yeah. I think a bit of chanting and cheering gives them the energy to lift that thing up. But yeah, it's a fair size and a fair weight.
It's good luck for the community, so hopefully it's good luck for you on race day.
I hope so. We need a little bit of luck. There's a lot involved in the cars now, and all the luck we can get, all the better. So hopefully a bit of that'll rub off on us.
Mountains and Japanese racetracks seem to go hand in hand. Fuji is just one of many circuits that has been carved into a hillside, and it more than suited the Esso Ultron team's Tiger of a Toyota Supra last year. All Japan GT racing is a two-driver affair. Gardner is employed by Team Le Mans, where his co-driver is 31-year-old Hideki Noda, a push-it-to-the-edge and sometimes beyond wheelman with Formula One and IndyCar experience.
You know, it's a team effort. There's no really number one status in the team. Noda, obviously, being Japanese, he's the official test driver. He's in Japan and he's at call at will to Toyota. If I was at will at call, I've got a long way to come from Sydney all the time. But look, I've got every faith in his ability. He's very good. He tries as much as he can to give me time in the car and vice versa. So, you know, this type of series and these races is all about a team effort, a partnership.
Team Le Mans will attempt to make it back-to-back wins at Fuji when the lights go green on race day. For now, though, the Pacific Rim Alliance of Gardner and Noda will have to content themselves with practice.
I'm going out first this morning, which is kind of unusual. Usually I'm the second half of the session, and but we've got a change of strategy, which is great, and I get to do a few miles this morning, so which is good because I missed out on the testing, and it started without me already, so I've got to go. See ya.
If the Masaki Shrine Festival was supposed to bring good luck, it must have taken a detour between Tokyo and Fuji. The reluctant number 6 makes it onto the track after not too much head scratching. But race week wasn't meant to begin like this.
Very, very ordinary start today. We had a bit of a change of plan at the last minute, and normally Noda does the first half of the hour and a half stint, and I do the second half. Because we've had so many minor or engine failures and bits and pieces through the last couple of tests, my time's been limited in the car, so I jumped up and down this morning and said, look, you know, if you expect a lot of me, you better give me some time in the car. So at the last minute, they changed their plans and put me up first this morning, which I appreciate, but then we had a electrical problem. It was a fuel pump failure. And then we lost probably another 10 minutes in the pits end, so, you know, my time is still shortened, but still, it was good to get out and do some lap.
Gardner's best lap is 1 minute 28.03 seconds, putting the team in 14th position on the timesheets and more than a second off the pace.
First corner, yeah, goes in, understeer, goes wide. Mm-hmm. Then when you're trying to get back, it then comes then a little bit oversteer, mid corner, then goes. Mm-hmm. But it's understeer first, first part of the corner, then a little bit oversteer, then pop, go.
The team is a long way off the times they were doing in a pre-season test at Fuji. And when Noda finishes the first practice session outside the top 10, the furrowed brow is the hottest fashion item in the Esso Ultron garage.
There's something wrong. Yeah. It's not the same.
You know what brakes? The car move a lot. Down here, when I brake, the car goes, whoa. And I went, I don't remember when that happened. And then I had new discs on when I went out, and then it kept biting the rears, locking up, so I wound 1.5 to the front, and it was better, but
still the car's moving, like you gotta chase the car on brakes.
A team meeting in which everyone from the windscreen polisher to the crew chief gets a say plots the course for the afternoon practice session. But not every lap will be spent looking for the fastest time.
I've changed the car a little bit. We've got new brake pads and discs all around, so I've got to run those in a little bit. Just check a couple of adjustments on the suspension that they made and get myself settled in. So it's probably going to take about 30 minutes or so, and then if everything's okay, we might run a new set of tyres. If not, we might change over to motor. So
a time of 1 minute 28.2 seconds on his sixth lap, and Gardner is the fifth fastest driver on the circuit. The car still wants to understeer, and it's a big problem in turn three, the fast right-hand corner known as the 100R.
Mid-corner in the 100R, just when you turn in, just understeers away to the outside, and you have to come up on the throttle to make it turn. So there's much too much understeer in the 100R. We lose a lot of time. Also, understeer first corner.
When Noda returns to pit lane after only two laps and complaining of the same problem, team boss Katsu Homma decides to change the Supra's differential. It's a gamble that may not work, and it will cost them 25 minutes of vital practice time.
We're having a tough day, isn't it? Although they say that a bad practice means a good race, so let's hope so. But yeah, when we're here testing, we did a 25 around here, which is obviously a couple of seconds quicker than we're going now. But then we found out that we had a differential that was quite a lot different, and it was actually half sort of broken at the time. Since then they've repaired and put a more of a locked up type diff in the car, but it won't turn now, it won't steer. We've got a lot of understeer. So I had it, and Noda went and did a few laps, and he had the same experience. So they've come in and they've changed now the differential without changing too much on the car. The car's actually working not too bad. We just got obviously no grip at the front, so hopefully by changing the diff we can find that lost 2 seconds that we're trying to get back.
Noda makes it back on track for the closing minutes of the session. But while Team Le Mans was stalled in the garage, their opposition in the Honda NSX camp have upped the ante, setting a fastest time in the low 1 minute 26 bracket. Day one finishes with nervous pacing and anxious faces. But when Noda clocks a lap of 1 minute 27.5, the Tiger is eighth fastest, and the diff change seems to have paid off.
Yeah, but it's still understeer or in what, slow corner or everywhere? So like more what we did, but more, yeah? So maybe more diff. You know when the initial turn, does it turn too quick now or is it okay? Because they came off one turn on the preload and it helped a little bit quicker turn, but then understeer still came and it didn't improve that. So we can get rid of that with a diff and maybe it's not too bad. And the brakes.
It's scary to drive.
Oh, really? The stability's still on brakes bad. Yeah. I nearly crashed earlier. Brake in the second corner and I brake and I went, whoa! Oh, and I nearly let go of the wheel. I thought I was going to hit the wall. And I got it back and went and braking around the corner and went, is that normal? Uh-huh. And it started because the road's all undulated and I braked and the car went, wow, it just got bigger. And you too? Same?
Wait, it happened to me.
No, it only happened to me once, and after that, I was scared.
Yeah.
With two qualifying sessions still to come on day two, there was enough track time to improve the number six Toyota, and more than enough time to get scared on and off the track.
When the crew of Team Le Mans come to Mount Fuji to race, they choose to stay here, the very curiously named Hotel 03. It's a nice hotel. By Japanese standards, very large rooms, twin beds, hot and cold running water, but it's a haunted hotel.
I have to tell you, this is a little bit of a creepy hotel.
It is, actually. Well, the legend is, and it goes, is that apparently, in fact, a lot of drivers won't stay here, or anyone will stay here, but the legend is that this hotel was built on top of a samurai cemetery here.
Oh, okay.
So the legend is that the samurais come out at night and are spooky and haunt you. So.
Now, you've had a couple of experiences here in the past.
Well, I normally never believe in ghosts, but last year, in fact, here's the room. Last year I stayed here and I shit my pants because I stayed in there. The TV came on by itself at about 2 or 3 in the morning. And I couldn't get it off for a while. The clock went backwards during the night and then back the other way during the day. There was banging outside the window because there's some real spooky woods out there. And every time I'd look, the bang would stop and there was no one out there, and I'd go to bed and it just went on and on all night. And there's stories of taps being turned on. And also, when I walked in there, there's this real cold atmosphere in there, and you can feel it. You're walking into like a refrigerator or something, so it's pretty spooky, I'll tell you.
It's quite the Amityville horror.
Oh, look, I don't believe in ghosts, I'm telling you, but it had me down in last year. So this year I said, look, I'm not staying in this hotel, but unfortunately, because there's accommodation was booked out, they put us back in here. But one stipulation I said was, I'll never stay in that room again.
Good move.
Exactly.
And they think racing cars can be scary.
Qualifying day at Fuji Speedway is the first chance the fans get to take a look at the action. Lots of them are here to add the latest snapshot or autograph of their favourite driver to their already bulging collection. The appearance of a driver in the paddock can cause a commotion, but the sighting of a campaign girl can fire off a photographic frenzy. The Race Queen fan clubs seemingly outnumbering the four-wheeled fans, it's easy to forget why everyone was here in the first place.
We've got to go and have a medical, which is the mandatory thing at every race. And which, I don't know why, but they drug test you and they blood pressure you and they strength test and all sorts of wacky things here. Everything's very strange in Japan.
Gardner, Mr. 100%.
I can't believe the crowds here on practice day. It is just incredible.
Yeah, it's a growing category. GT at the moment is obviously the most popular category in Japan and growing rapidly at the moment. So, yeah, it's pretty big. I mean, you've got a big population here, 130 million to choose from. So, yeah, it's a pretty popular cast, and the Japanese don't like spending their money too. They love it, you know, like coming to the races, seeing the celebrities, and you know, there's not only just a lot of good drivers here, there's a lot of famous drivers as well. I mean, movie stars and actors and singers and so on. So it's got a lot of attention, a lot of pull for the crowd.
Are they big fans of yours because of what you did in 500cc motorcycle racing, or because what you're doing now in GT racing?
Oh, I think it's a bit of both. I think obviously there's a lot of respect now for the four-wheel stuff, but you know, the nice thing about it is I've got a lot of fans that have, you know, at that age when I was riding bikes, when I was in my 20s, and those similar age guys have now got older and had children, and have families, and they've got bought nice cars, and they're fairly well off now. They've got established jobs and so on, so they don't mind, you know, coming to the races, and they know the name, so they come and go, oh, I was a big fan of yours on the bike days, and I've come to see your race. So it's kind of nice to drag those fans with me, and yeah, nice to come meet them again. And they've got photos and books of those days on my bikes, and which I'm very proud of. But it now has moved on to the car day, so it's kind of fun, and it's kid building, which is great.
So what did they change on the car last night?
Diff.
Yeah, diff.
Hey.
You have to.
Oh, this again?
Yep.
Ooh, that's all I can do.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, and this side?
Yeah.
That's all?
Perfect.
Okay. Oh, it's coffee time?
No.
Coffee?
Japanese tea.
Oh, tea.
Yeah.
You have milk? No milk? Oh. Cheers. Oh.
Drink it.
Whew. You have some milk for me? Sugar? No sugar? No sugar?
Card. Card.
Hey, check that amount out. Oh, is that all you could do?
After proving that they're fit enough to take part in the space shuttle program, it's time to get down to the business at hand. First qualifying consists of only 40 minutes track time, and each driver has to have a turn at the wheel. With Noda's ability to be fast on his first flying lap, it's his job to try and put the car on the front row of the grid.
Fast lap always, high is always very good. So for mentally, it's very difficult to go fast on fast lap. You're not warmed up yourself, but you have to trust everything, and you just have to concentrate and go for it.
The GT lap record at Fuji is a blistering 1 minute 25.01 seconds. Second lap out from pit lane, and Noda puts the reborn Supra on provisional pole. Only half a second off the lap record, and more than 2 seconds faster than either he or Gardner had managed the day before. Provisional pole is the good news. The bad news comes 2 laps later at turn one. The fastest driver on the circuit has put the Tiger on the beach, and the Esso Ultron crew ready themselves for some hasty repairs. The pointy end of the grid is only a dream for those not prepared to test the limits of friction, and Noda is left to be philosophical after his off-track excursion.
You know, being a professional driver for qualifying, sometimes you have to drive the car 100%, sometimes 110%, you have to control the car. That means, you know, you're being professional drivers. If you are within 100% of the car, like 70%, 80% of the car, that's not professional. Qualifying, you have to do everything.
As the car makes it back to pit lane the slow way, the pressure to post a slick time has claimed more victims, including last year's series champion, Eric Comas.
Like that
50.
Was you in the sand?
Yeah, I just break out, Amber 50, lock the angle, off brake. I went sideways, lock again, break again, lock the on the opposite side. And
Where do you brake, 150?
150, yeah.
Yeah, same.
about the same.
The one constant in a frantic first qualifying session is the form of the number 18 Honda NSX, driven by Juichi Wakasaka and Katsutomo Kanishi. The duo sneak inside Noda's best time by 0.07 of a second to sit on provisional pole, as the search for more speed continues in the Team Le Mans garage.
So car is a bit understeer, then we want to take off via downforce, but we'll be more unstable at the brake.
Yeah, I think no, don't do it. I think don't take any downforce off, no. Because for the race you don't want that, you know?
You're mowing.
Yeah.
For race, tire wears are more bad.
Yeah, exactly. More sliding.
I think
leave it, you know. Already now I think maximum.
Oh yes?
Maximum off, you know. If anything, maybe a little bit more wing. Just my opinion. You know?
Yeah, maybe.
I think it's nervous now, you know?
Right.
It's enough.
The dilemma isn't restricted to aerodynamics. If the team finishes the second qualifying session in the top three, they'll be lumped with a minimum 10 kilogram penalty for the 67 laps of the race. It's the lone issue on which opinions differ in the SO camp.
Tomorrow's the race. Now we can win tomorrow.
Honda.
Yeah. With a little bit of luck, I think we can do it.
Pole position ends up being decided in a two-car Toyota versus Honda showdown. Noda outdoes his morning fireworks and closes to within a tenth of the lap record. One lap after Noda goes quickest, the Honda hits the top of the timesheets with a lap that is just 0.005 of a second off the circuit record.
He's having a go, but he won't do it. It's a good lap time by the Honda. The Honda's very, very fast, very quick this year. But its reliability's always been a problem, so they beat us by a tenth, and hopefully their car's unreliable tomorrow, and that might mean good for us, but... Yeah, it would have been good to have pole, but, you know, the race is tomorrow, more importantly. And, yeah, Hideki's good at putting one or two laps together. And he would have got just about the best out of the car, so that's about where it's going to lay. And it's a pretty good lap time, but as I said, the number 18 Honda, that's a good car this year, and it's going to be hard to beat.
That's maximum.
I was watching on TV, working the wheel a lot. Like, having a go.
That's good. Scary.
Was it?
Under the brake, it's hard like this.
I know, I told you.
That's so scary.
I said to you that under braking is bad. I mean, it's a weak point of the car, you know? Oh, that's okay. Hey. On hindsight, it would have been better if you had waited. We'd be now fourth on the grid, looking at the lap times. We'd now be fourth. It would have been perfect.
Pole position is happy for sponsor and for Toyota. Then second is still good. But fourth is a strategy for championship. It's good.
So the extra weight is worth the prestige that comes with pole position.
Mm. Yep.
But I suppose now we now get 10 kilos, unfortunately, for being second. And I guess now we've got to try and get a good race set up with a full tank this afternoon, see what the race tyres are like on a consistent basis, and make sure the balance is pretty good, you know, for distance now. So, you know, the car's done its job to go fast, but now it's got to go and do the endurance leg.
From the faltering beginnings of first practice to the tension of a charge to the front row of the grid, Team Le Mans would win any award handed out for the most improved car over the first 2 days.
I think you should dry it first in the morning in the warm-up. I think that's a much better braking package, which is where our weak spot is. I think you'll be surprised that that's a lot better. It's not straight and not having to chase the steering wheel everywhere. It's, oh, and you go, oh, I should have went more. Again, oh, maybe more next time, you know? And brake pedal's good. Gearbox is a bit
please check the gearbox, a bit notchy.
Yeah, we'll pick up
the apart from that, no, I think good balance. Much better than the beginning of the session. It's too much oversteer. Too much. Particularly for the race.
The qualifying might be over, but the practice continues in the shadows of a grandstand that will burst into life tomorrow.
What's a good time for a pit stop for your team?
Well, around about the 30-second mark. You know, you can't refuel and change tyres the same time as the regulation is, so usually the pit stop consists of Hideki stops, he jumps out, I'm getting in, the car is up, changing tyres, the belts and everything are done up, and then when the tyres are on, then they refuel it, and all that takes about 30 seconds all up.
Is that? I felt it go like this. Like that. There, yeah. How close was that? That would have broke my foot.
Gardner left foot makes it through pit stop practice intact.
39.3. Okay.
And maybe the good luck of the Misaki Shrine Festival found its way to Fuji after all. Only one more night with the restless ghosts of the samurai warriors stands between a tired Esso Ultron crew and race day.
Who've been camping outside the gates all night since about, since yesterday. And they sleep in their cars, so they're dedicated fans, which is great, you know, it's good to see that. But I certainly wouldn't be doing it, that's for sure. I think I like the creature comforts of a hotel, even if they've got ghosts in them.
Race day means an early start for everyone. The race is still 7.5 hours away, but even at this early hour, it's hard to focus on anything apart from the 67 laps that will begin at 2:30.
We do some more driver change this morning? No? It'll be okay?
I was having trouble.
There you go. Couple of times.
Yeah, because I kept getting. Normally I put my leg in near the clutch. This time my SI, I was putting it in and folding it, and I was kind of stuck. My head was on the bar and my leg was in. I'm gonna get in. I think I'm gonna put my leg through and sort of slide in again. You know, I was stuck yesterday a couple of times.
The morning's first assignment is a half-hour warm-up session, and it ensures that Japan's spring weather isn't solely responsible for the occasional butterfly.
Oh, I'm getting starting to work up in nerves and so on, but that's really important, you know, because you don't want to go out into a race not prepared and not G'd up and not have butterflies, because that just gives you that extra edge of performance and obviously keeps you in the safe margin as well.
Winner's trophy.
I hope so.
Yeah.
I hope so.
There'll be plenty of good luck passed around before the lights go green, but there's no ritual that needs to be observed.
No, not really. Nah. Just try and be calm and not get too flustered before a race. I think you get into the race and panic and you'll mess up and have an off and have a shunt. So try and just have everything under control. Have everything prepared, like I'm doing now, just little things. Keeps me occupied and hopefully there'll be no more.
Ready to win today.
Warm-up is an uneventful session for the SO Ultron team, although the same can't be said for the entire field.
Sri Lanka から RGS Mirage.
Team Sri Lanka will watch the race from pit lane after their entry turns itself into a mobile barbecue. First round winner Eric Comas will make it onto the grid, but the number one Nissan GTR will need plenty of work after co-driver Masami Kagayama tangled with a backmarker.
Has a little bit understeer, has a little bit oversteer. I think the balance isn't bad. If you check the right-hand front tyre, I lost the wheel and I might have a small flat spot. It's not too bad, but just check please.
The last corner, you go in and mid-corner, it feels like a little bit oversteer, but then if you kick the power on, it seems to sit down and then start to push the front a little bit. Has a little bit understeer, come back over the crest of the hill, but I think that's safe. I think that's a better safe proposition. Oh, look, easy. You know, if you want to turn, it'll go, but you're trying to keep the wheel straight, and with a little bit understeer, you can feel the front tyres just pushing a little bit, but I think that's good because you're getting a better balance of tyre wear for the front to the rear.
While the spectators fill every vantage point, the technicians at Toyota Racing Development have one final look at the telemetry from each of the eight Supras they'll run in the 300-kilometre long race. They might be grand touring cars by name, but these machines are bred to race from the ground up.
Wayne, there's a bit about the car which, as far as aerodynamics go, reminds you of Formula One racing.
There's a lot of Formula One technology in this car. You know, as you can see, it started out as a basic road car, but obviously it's very heavily modified, not only on the outside, but also underneath the car. And it's what we call, you draw the air underneath the car, creates a vacuum, and makes the car stick to the road. So all this technology, as you can see, it's a flat-bottom car, is basically Formula One technology developed into this GT car.
Let's take a look at the engine and suspension.
This is a 2-litre four-cylinder engine that's obviously turbocharged with all the goodies as well on it, that I can't talk about. But look, it produces a lot of power. The difficult thing about it is that it's a very hard car on the throttle to drive, having turbo lag.
But the nice thing about it is it's a very small engine and it's lightweight. So, you know, you've got to have a compromise in the whole situation. But, yeah, it produces a lot of power and we can adjust anything in the car, boost control, delivery of power and so on while we're driving. So that helps the tyre condition.
Why, and this suspension is not exactly what you'd find in your normal family car?
No. In fact, it's all covered in now and you can't see properly, but obviously it's race prepared. But again, the whole rear end is actually out of F1 car technology with aero arms, as you can see, rocker arm suspension, which gives it a better linear curve. The gearbox and diff is in the back, like a Formula One car. So really, we've only got the engine in the front, then we've got a tail shaft, and then we've got the diff and gearbox in the back of the car. So what that does is give the car very much a 50-50 weight balance.
Is there anything you change immediately you get in the car when Hideki comes out, you jump in at a pit stop? Is there anything you change immediately between his settings and your settings?
Not really, we're pretty close. We might have a few clicks in the roll bar. You know, I might have a bit softer front roll bar, or he might have a bit softer front rubber, or a bit harder. So, you know, you can actually change the setup of the car. As the fuel, as you use and burn fuel, the car becomes lighter. You can adjust the car as you're going along on just how it turns into a corner or how it comes off a corner by the roll bar adjustment here. So he might come in the pits on an empty tank, and then I've got to, well, he'll have fairly soft bars, then I've got to go out on a full tank. I'll probably pull the bars up tighter to make the car turn a bit better. So, you know, you just got to play with the balance, also the brake balance. He'll change it as his stint finishes as well. So, you know, it's really hard and really important to find a driver that has a similar feel, a similar style, and obviously similar size, that you can relate to and want the same sort of setup. So Hideki and I work very, very well together. We're good mates, and he's a very quick driver. So I think it's a pretty strong combination.
With the sequential gears, you don't actually need to use the clutch during a race.
No, Hideki actually uses left foot brake. I did last year with ABS, but this year I've gone back to right foot brake. And going up to the gearbox, no, I don't use a clutch at all. And I don't use a clutch. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. Depends on the corner downshift as well. But Hideki doesn't use the clutch at all when he's driving, only to get out of pit lane.
Okay. Clutch or no clutch, he couldn't get out of pit lane at the moment. Any fan with the pit lane pass, and there seems to be an awful lot of them, can stroll up and down Gasoline Alley and for 1,000 yen get their photo taken with his or her favourite drivers. All the money goes to charity and they raise plenty. Now, seeing as it is for a good cause...
There we go. Here we go, boys.
Oh, it's the one. Hello,
I'm coming in.
What are you up to?
I'm coming to with you guys. Want to get a photo? Smile. Thank you.
No
thanks
worries.
For us. Good luck.
Thanks.
Good luck this afternoon.
Thanks.
No. The last nut has been tightened, the final settings adjusted, and the tyre compound has been chosen.
So maybe beginning of the race I have a chance. I try to pass him. After that, I don't know. I have to see from there. I just have to try not to think too much.
Is that a big part of it? Try and just live in the moment, not try and get too far ahead of yourself?
Yeah, I think the race is very long. If I pass the car to Wayne within a few seconds from Honda, then he can do the job.
Noda leaves pit lane for the siding lap. And the countdown to the start of the race at 2:30 has shrunk from hours to minutes.
You've been known over here as Mr. 100%, 100% today?
Well, I always give it 100%. I always try hard. You know, I guess that's where the mongrels in me, you know, that's where they get it from. So, look, I'll go out there and do my best. But priority today is obviously to finish. We need points. Keep out of trouble. So, yeah, I'll push as hard as I can, but try not overdo it as well. So,
It's a long day.
Is there a plan for the team before the start of the race? How many laps that Noda might do, or then how many laps before you come into the car?
Yeah, we're talking around about 30, 31 for Noda, depending on pace cars and yellow flags and obviously any dramas out there. And my stint is planned at the moment for 37 laps, so I'll get to finish off a bit more than half of the race. So, but that may change depending on, as I said, pace cars or accidents or red flags or who knows, you know. So just got to be prepared for it, for anything.
The yellow Takata Honda waits at the front of the grid, a hot favourite to win after dominating both practice and qualifying.
Well, they're going to be really hard to beat today, Honda. That's a new car this year, and it's very, very fast. I mean, looking at it this morning, it was nearly a second quicker than us on a full tank, so it's going to be hard to hold back. But, you know, a lot of things can happen in a day, in a race. So I'd say, you know, they're the main ones, obviously, but I think Kroom in the Nissan, who's qualified third, Michael's really fast. He's aggressive, he likes to push a bit, so I'm hoping that, you know, we can keep Noda and him apart and they're not going to fight too much out there.
Well, we hope from now on that we can...
Just hang in there, we'll be right. Just keep the pressure on and push the Honda as much as you can, and I will, and I think we'll be okay. Good luck, buddy.
Okay.
Good luck.
From the rolling start, Noda tries to outdrag the Honda to the first corner, but the pole sitter makes no mistakes.
GTR が内から行く。外から黄色いボディ、高田ドーム NSX。さらにはその外からエッソウルトロンタイガースープラ。
The leaders make it through turn one unscathed, although the same can't be said of several drivers back through the field. By the end of lap three, Juichi Wakasaka has pushed his number 18 Honda to a 2.9 second lead over the Tiger, which has a freight train of cars right behind it. The gap between first and second continues to grow, and with the Honda circulating almost a second per lap faster, there's concern on the pit lane wall and in the garage. Losing time hand over fist was not in the Toyota game plan.
Not really. Looks like he's struggling to hold off the Nissan and the McLaren and basically the next four or five guys. So I was hoping the car would have a bit more pace than that against the others, but not. So we're going to have a real battle all day, it looks like.
Driver Michael Kroom in the number 2 Nissan GTR relegates Noda to third place by lap 12, and there's no sign that the attacks from behind will stop there.
He has some trouble, has some problem.
Lap 26. Just over a third of the race is gone, and Noda falls back into fourth place, more than 17 seconds off the lead. If the Honda goes the distance, there's no way they can catch it, even with 41 laps remaining. As Gardner prepares for his stint, his thoughts are no longer of winning. The aim now is for a lower step on the podium. But that goal is about to move further from reach when the previous night's pit stop practice comes apart at the seams.
VSV off. VSV off.
Toyota Supra rejoins the action in 11th position. The pit stop was a full 10 seconds slower than scheduled, and Gardner will need more than a good old-fashioned dose of mongrel to track down the leaders. A refueling problem is to blame for the slow changeover, but Noda is more than aware that his troubles on the track have put Team Le Mans in a difficult position.
I changed brake balance to the rear. It's maximum to the rear, but still no brake on the rear, just front, so couldn't stop.
The brakes had improved a lot during qualifying. You've made a lot of ground with the brakes over the last day and a half. That must be disappointing to have a brake problem in the race.
Well, of course it's disappointing, but how can I say, this is amazing.
After five laps behind the wheel, Gardner has the number six circulating faster than any car on the circuit and finds himself up in eighth position as other teams come in to make their driver change. Included amongst them is the race leader. With Katsutomo Kanishi now driving, the Takata Honda crew hold a 9-second advantage over their nearest rival. While the remainder of the field makes their compulsory pit stop, the man known as the Wollongong Whiz for his exploits on two wheels continues to tear off quick times, and by lap 41 has moved into sixth place. His progress through the field draws the possibility of a smile from Gardner's pit crew. There's more to come, but on a circuit with few passing points, patience becomes every bit as vital as horsepower. Has an unassailable 14-second lead. The real race is now for third, and it's to be fought out between two Toyotas, Gardner's orange and black Tiger versus the all-blue Supra driven by Yuji Tashikawa. Gardner closes to within 7/10 of a second of third position, and there are still 9 laps remaining. The pursuit lasts until the final few laps, when it becomes obvious that Team Le Mans will have to settle for fourth place. They'll be left to think about what might have been if it wasn't for the precious seconds wasted in their one pit stop. Tanishi can afford a wave to the spectators on the last lap, and the commentator's superlatives are his as he wins by 14 seconds.
第2戦 富士 高田 同盟 レース X 優勝! 今チェッカーフラッグを受けました。2番手以降に大きな差を上げて。
There'll be no trophy presentation for Gardner and Noda, just the warm handshakes and memories of the chase that go to the men who missed the podium.
Good job anyway, well done.
Wait, tried.
Yeah.
I'm trying. Tried hard.
How's that way?
Tiring. Had to fight back, you know, that was hard work. Car was hard work. The car in front of us was a little bit better and stronger, which was disappointing considering it was a Toyota. That was a hard battle. Rear tyres were gone in the end and I just couldn't get any more traction off the corners and I was sliding and I couldn't push any harder, and that was my limit on the day. So Yeah, with what we had, it wasn't too bad, but, you know, it's not so good, not so bad, but it was a good fight anyway.
Good job.
I tried hard.
Good
job. No more tyres left. I just, boom. I tried hard, but come back, but no more tyres finished at the end. Oh. But good fun. Good job.
You did a good job today.
I tried hard, but not good enough, you know?
You did good.
Thanks.
I appreciate it.
Good love.
Love time, that's good.
Consistent. 27.9, 28.0. Trying to keep it in there, but had nothing left.
It's very hard for tyres, this car.
Very hard. Three tyres finished. That's where Selmo has.
The beginning of the race, I pushed, trying to keep up. So doing that, you know, it's very hard for tyres. And only five laps, tyres gone.
Last three laps, I could hardly stay on the track. I was turning in sideways, off sideways, couldn't get any traction, just spinning. I couldn't do the last corner flat anymore. It was just moving away on me. I went, no, stop, say bye-bye and have fun today. I don't want to throw it in the weeds now.
There is only ever one winner, of course, but no matter where you finish, the one thing you can always count on in Japan are the fans. Waiting for one more photo, looking for one more autograph. The fans' loyalty is something you can bank on. But those good luck festivals? Now, that's another matter.
Go!